It's slime time that Slime Tribal product got printed, and I'm going to review this new secret lair for Oathbreaker. This is Chad again, and I'm welcoming you to DaBomb's Secret Lairs. In this episode, I'm going to review the recently reprinted cards in the newest secret lair drop, Slime Time, for the Oathbreaker format. If you're new here, I make Oathbreaker content, and if that's what you're into, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and turn on notifications so you know when I make new content for you. Before we start, I just want to say that my evaluation is based on flavor, financial value, and playability of the cards in this Secret Lair product. I will be giving the sections a ranking from 1 to 10 because it provides a little more nuance, one rating, and I will be grading the cards as we go, and at the end I will provide a letter grade for this drop. First things first, let's cover a little bit of flavor. Flavor is important in ranking a specialized product like Secret Lairs, as this is often one of the strongest reasons behind making a Secret Lair purchase. Can I just say how much I love this art style? For me, artist Wizard of the Barge really hit it out of the park. And if you like his style, I will have a link to his store in the description to this video. This style probably reminds most people of Adventure Time, Ugly Americans, or even the card game Epic Spell Wars at Skullfire Mountain. The colors chosen in this art also gives these cards a fairly toxic feeling, which is great for these slimes. And the choice of a cityscape for some of the art is very enthralling to me. This style of art is a great way to break with the standard card style, and due to the uniqueness and cost, it functions to bling out a deck at the same time. I don't know if it was the artist's intention, but I feel that when we look at the cards organized in the following order, it tells a very interesting story flavor-wise. So in this order, you can see here, I'm going to actually break down these cards one at a time. So in Acidic Slime, we can see a wizard has screwed up making his potion and this slime has escaped and is running away. And the flavor text reads, "The merchant said their newt extract was cauldron safe." So in this first one, we can see the slime escaping. A little bit later in Scavenging Ooze, this slime has been allowed to eat garbage and grow and rampage and even eat people at this point, growing bigger. And the flavor text here is, "Some days it just feels like trash. Others days it could really go for some people." Crotic Ooze shows this slime out in the wild getting stronger and stronger, finally physically just attacking people to eat it. "It looks like currant jam and smells like death and tastes like a little bit of both." So the idea that this slime tastes a little bit like grape jelly and death is very hilarious to me. Moving on in our story, the slime has now grown into this massive legendary creature, the Mimoplasm, and so the wizard has come back and decided that he needs to defeat it. And you can see him there, standing on the peak of this mountain, being just drizzled on. There is no flavor text here, but in Void Slime, we can see that the slime wins this fight when the wizard tries to cast Cyclonic Rift and takes a face full of mucus. So, I think that's an interesting story where we have a wizard that failed, a slime escaped, and the wizard failed to rein it back in. So, for this drop, despite my personal feelings, I will be giving it a 7 out of 10 for flavor. I believe the flavor of the art combined with the story and the flavor text is good. But after talking with others, I found that the art is an instant turnoff for them. And that meant that, like most secret lairs, they are either loved or hated with very little room between when it comes to unique art styles. Next, I want to tackle the secret lair's value. Any product's cost is a deciding factor in whether or not the product will see play or purchase. At a cost of $29 for 5 cards, this lair is on one of the more reasonable purchases of this product line. So if you wanted to fill your life with slime, this one's a little bit more doable. And since these cards are available as singles, no player is forced to buy this premium product at this price if they don't care for the aesthetic. But for giggles, let's do a breakdown anyway. Acidic Slime for 3-2 Green has an average price of 35 cents. Scavenging Ooze for 1-1 Green, the most expensive version, costs $5.44. Necrotic Ooze usually costs $2.50. The Mimoplasm is $3.55, and Void Slime is $6.52. The total of the individual cards in this secret lair adds up to about $18.36. Plus, there is always a mystery prize. Up to this point, each secret lair has included a War of the Spark stained glass planeswalker, which is a boon to those of us in the Oathbreaker format. However, these planeswalkers are valued anywhere from $2.98 for, say, Teo the Shield Mage, all the way up to $159.99 for Ugin the Ineffable. So, with the right Oathbreaker included in the box, you may exceed the estimated value. However, looking at the prices on mtgstocks.com, you will find that the financial value of secret lair cards that have been reprinted can swing drastically, sometimes being as low as $0 or unlisted, so it is hard to prognosticate whether or not these cards will be worth more than the standard singles they are based on. So for financial value, I'm going to give this product a 7 out of 10 or a C, since the value of these products can be very swingy. Finally, let's look at Slime Time from a playability level. I'm going to go through this card by card. Acidic Slime for 3-2 Green is a 2-2 ooze with Death Touch. When it enters the battlefield, you can destroy target artifact, enchantment, or land. Acidic Slime is a very good answer card. Probably still has a home in most people's mono-green Oathbreaker decks. Scavenging Ooze for 1-1 Green is a 2-2 ooze. If we pay 1, we can exile target card from graveyard. If the exiled card was a creature card, we put a 1-1 counter on it and gain 1 life. In Oathbreaker, life gain is quite a bit stronger than, say, a format like EDH, where we're starting a lot higher. Growing this simply by removing other players' graveyards is this fun kind of hate that keeps graveyard decks from operating at their most optimum level, and also gives us an ace in the hole. Necrotic Ooze for 2 and 2 black is a 4-3 ooze, and as long as it is on the battlefield, it has all activated abilities of all creature cards in all graveyards. That's a really fun effect with the right type of activated abilities in your graveyard. This can be very cool. I've never really seen anyone pull it off, but for 4 mana, again, it will find a home in a lot of decks. Next up, we have the Mimoplasm. Before I read any of the card, I'd just like to say that this card is the bummer in this set for us in the Oathbreaker community, since we don't currently have a Planeswalker commander that has the same color identity as this card. We can't actually include the Mimoplasm in any of our decks, making this one card in this secret lair unplayable for us. Finally, Void Slime for 1 green and 2 blue mana says counter target spell activated ability or triggered ability. What's really cool about this instant is it can stop planeswalker abilities, it can stop emblem abilities, and it can counter spells. So there's a lot of things this card can do for us. And this version, I think, is very cartoonish and fun. So I could certainly see either buying one of the originals, which doesn't fit my budget usually, or buying the secret lair simply because I like this art. Since many of these cards are useful and playable, with one noticeable exception to this rule, I think this lair deserves an 8 out of 10 for whether or not it's playable in Oathbreaker. So, with a score of 7 out of 10 for flavor, since the art has turned many people I know off, 7 out of 10 for value, and 8 out of 10 for playability, Slime Time has an average score of 73%, landing it with a C grading. Now, this is my opinion, and if you love the art style as much as I do, or the idea of having some Slime Tribal cards in a different style, certainly pick this up. I'm not telling you not to. This is just advice. Now that we have evaluated Slime Time, the secret lair drop, what other cards do you think I should review, and what cards do you most want to see get the secret lair treatment? If you're looking for any cards to update your collection, this channel is now supported by TCGplayer.com. Alternatively, if all you need is your own custom gaming equipment, please check out Inked Gaming. I will be placing my affiliate links for both of these sites in the description below. If you are interested in learning more about Oathbreaker, check out this playlist here, or if you want to see a YouTube video that has been curated for you, then check out the video link next to it. Just remember, I can't do these videos without you, and I wouldn't, so please do remember to subscribe, and I hope this video blew your mind.